Guys,
it's been a minute since I've done a Patreon reaction and a Patreon request. It's almost like I gotta warm up to it again. All right, whatever. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano the Third. Y'all guys are the third family. If you're subscribed, if you're not subscribed and you want to become part of this family, at the end of the video, when you like what you see, click the subscribe button bottom right hand corner. Now, the highest tier on my Patreon gets one request per month. And let me tell you, when I say I've been slacking, I've been slacking. So we're gonna be doing like nonstop Patreon requests unless somebody puts out some hot new banger that I gotta like review and react to. Obviously, RIP Mac, I gotta be doing the album review when that comes out on Friday. But until then, Patreon requests. And as you can see today by the title that you clicked on, by the stupid joke that I made at the beginning cold open of the video, as you can tell by the lights, we got another NF track. To be honest, I don't think I've heard Warm Up before. I don't think I've heard this track before. I might have and just like skipped over it as I was trying to like breeze through his whole catalog as fast as possible to catch up for the search. So I might have heard it and skipped over it. I don't even know. Doesn't sound familiar, but we're gonna see what we got today. This request comes to you from Kelly TSM or 30 Seconds to Mars. Avi, a very big 30 Seconds to Mars fan, as you can tell by the name. So Kelly, as always, I appreciate your Patreon support. Everybody else, I appreciate your Patreon support that's on Patreon. If you want to potentially support the channel at one of the lower tiers, 5, 10 bucks, what have you, here and there, help the channel go. Feel free to click the first link in the description and see what we got going on over there, along with the Discord. But that's enough talking for today. You know, we got to just go ahead and hop off into this thing and see exactly what we got and see what type of heat NF is bringing. This is like 3 years ago. So as you know, if you watch this channel, he like started out very basic and became a very complex writer. Like, he had a lot of potential and he fulfilled that potential, and this is like right in the middle of that. So I want to see what he sounds like right in the middle, because there's a clear difference between beginning Nate and the search Nate. As I always say, follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, no spaces, just like the channel. Links in the description if you're too lazy to type it out, and let's go.
Yeah. I'm the type to rent a hotel room just to feel at home. I'm the type to rent a hotel room just to be alone. Yeah. I got an issue with people pretending they like what they don't. Please don't bring up my issues unless you gon' deal with your own. Please don't try to pretend like you keep it real though.
Yeah. Don't bring up my issues unless you trying to deal with your own. Boy, don't be speaking on my shit when you can't even deal with your shit. I can't stand these fake people. It's a bar. And also the green tin is there, so I don't know if it fits like in the storyline of like the journey that we went on and I just skipped it or what, but the green tin's there, the green tin's here, and that vibes all the way around.
Please don't bring up my issues unless you gon' deal with your own. Please don't try to pretend like you keep it real though. Yeah, it's funny that you got a lot of money, but that money doesn't buy you skills though. I don't care if I am on the billboards, on the killing spree, I'm about to kill more. Got a chain on, you pay the mill for. I mean, what you people even live for? I'll write raps, you steal yours and more. We just getting warmed up.
Bruh, we just getting warmed up, he said. Cause we're only like 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe 10 bars in at this point. He said, you got a lot of money, but that money don't buy you skills though. Like, you got a lot of money because you just stay watered down to produce to the masses. It doesn't take skill to do that. You're just a talking puppet for the A&Rs. You're a talking puppet for the record label. And he said, you got a chain on you that you paid a mill for, but what you even living for? That's just material shit. You're not impressing no one other than the people that are in that same low state of mind as you. And he said, I write raps and you steal yours? Back 3 years ago, I could definitely understand why he said that, because like a lot of rap was feeling all very the same. It all just kind of like congealed into one thing, which people called mumble rap. But if that's what gets you going, you do you. All we're trying to say over here is that $1 million chain really isn't anything to be too impressed about.
I'll write raps, you steal yours and more. We just getting warmed up. Yeah, I said I was coming, I warned you. So close to the fans, I feel like they're riding my tour. But you wanna know what I do in my downtime? They come to my fortress. I apologize for all the corpses. It's a mess right now, but I haven't had time to put the rappers in the coffins.
He said, I apologize for all the corpses. It's a mess right now. I haven't had the time because I've been touring. I've been busy making music to put all the bodies of these rappers in their coffins. And he said, I'm so close to my fans, it feels like they're on the tour bus. Fire. I love Nate when he's like this is Nate's bag right here, and this is him in his bag. You know? I love that shit.
We ain't talked in like 6 years. Why you writing me now? I just turned 100K down just to keep the brand looking right now. I ain't bragging about the money. I'm just saying I ain't controlled by the bank account or the bank amounts. I'm a businessman, but don't touch my money. I don't play around. Lights
out when the mic's out. The music videos have gotten so much better because, like, just watching that right now, like, why were we, like, from a bird's eye view just looking at the street for 12 seconds? Like, that didn't do anything to the story of the music video. So even his production on his music videos has gotten better. Because now every single, like, frame of his music videos today have meaning. They have symbolism. There's a story behind it. There's backstory that you need to, like, find the history about and go on the journey that I took to understand what's going on in his music videos. But right now we're just on a rooftop going in, and then we just have drone shots, just random drone shots. That's the progress that I'm talking about. New Nate would never put a 15 second clip of just the street for no reason.
Lights out when the mic's out, about to hit the west coast, hype crowd. I just put a record out. What you think I'm about to pipe down now? I've been looking for a beat, look what I found. I mean, everything is coming out of my mouth. Try to tell me, yeah, I ain't had a right sound.
Bro, he's just going in. He's just talking to all the critics and all the non-believers back in the day. Like, yo, you were talking shit, said that I would never make it. Look where I'm at now. Nate is basically like the ugly chick or like the ugly dude in high school that the fine chick or the fine dude would like never give the time of day. But then now he's like a 10 or 12 and like you're like, damn, when did the glow up come? And it's like, yo, it's been there, but I was trying to tell you and you didn't want to listen. That's dope when people speak their dreams into existence. Like, he's been dreaming about this shit the whole time and he knew he had it in him, regardless of the doubters, regardless of the non-believers. Fire. And did y'all see that little edit, that do-do-do, like the way the frame went whenever he like said, I've been looking for a beat, look what I found. Ooh, look at this.
I just put a record out, what you think I'm about to pipe down? Nah, I've been looking for a beat, look what I found.
Do-do-do-do. Ooh.
I just put a record out, what you think I'm about to pipe down? Nah, I've been looking for a beat, look what I found. Ooh. I mean, everything is coming out of my...
Fire. Alright.
Two records in a bag, I ain't done no. What's coming next year? Let me hear the drum roll. Don't flow. Anybody wanna be the one to make an issue out of nothing? I'ma hit you with my iPhone. I know, I'm a little out of hand now. I ain't looking for a handout. You ain't like what I was doing last year, which is funny because you're looking like a fan now. Are you a fan now?
I kinda. You looking like a fan now? Ooh, boy. That's that shit I like, son. Like, I told you so. Like Randy Travis. I told you so. But you had to go. You know? That's a fire ass country track, by the way. Check it out. Randy Travis, I told you so. Carrie Underwood too, but like, you know, you can't beat the OG. But one thing that I will criticize, and I always criticize Nate for this, is that like, especially old Nate, is that like the flow isn't as smooth. Like the flow is much smoother right here than it was in Mansion. But like that iPhone line just threw the whole setup for the punchline off because it only rhymed one syllable. And that's not enough for me. I come from listening to people who rhyme 3-4 syllables at a time each time. So when you're not rhyming more than just phone, he said drum roll, dumb flow. See, that's okay because now we got a little smoothness. We got a little fluidity in the voice, in the vocals, in the lyrics. But then we go from drum roll, dumb flow, iPhone. Like, I was expecting something better than that. And it's not a bad line. It's just like when I hear it and I hear rappers who are at this elite level of rap, who are like in the public eye, who have record deals, when I hear them rap and rhyme only one syllable, like, that shit bothers me for some reason. If I can make a poem and I can make a rhyme and make something make sense and make it have like rhyme two or three syllables, like, why can't you? You know? Maybe that's just me though. But that line about looking like a fan now, fire, for sure.
Like a fan now, are you a fan now? I kinda miss being broke. Now let me go back to my old days when I used to walk into high school and hand out my CD in hallways. I told all my teachers that I'd be a rapper. They smile and look at me, okay. That's a pretty nice dream, but you better get a real job. No way. Yeah, I live what you dreaming. I could do this while I'm sleeping. I ain't the type that'll bring up your name for nothing, but please don't give me a...
Hold on. I had to pause in the middle of the bar because I got it late. He said, I live what you're dreaming. I do this when I'm sleeping. Bro, see, that's the writing that I want. That's a bar. Everybody in the past has said, my life is a movie. My life's a dream. Like, I'm living out your dreams. But no one ever says, I'm living out what your dreams. And it's so easy to me. I do this when I'm sleeping. So, like, I'm living dreams because I'm sleeping because it's so easy. That's fire. All right, let's go back because...
Yeah, I live what you dreaming. I could do this while I'm sleeping. I ain't the type that'll bring up your name for nothing, but please don't give me a reason. I'm on the edge now. I ain't playing with you. Never really been a fan of taking pictures. I'm just being honest. Yeah, I'll take it with your show selling now. Better get your tickets. Oh, Lord. I got a love for the fans. I can express what it feels like. Sometimes I wonder if it's even real life. Sometimes I look at the past and think about how I got here in the first place. You know the glove is my birthplace. I don't want to be rude, but I can get you on. Say nothing for me, do it all the time.
Yo, the energy, the fire, the beat. Even the music video was fire, and it's not really anything that's fire. You know what I'm saying? Whoever edits this music video is what's making the music video good. Low-ass budget music video for sure. All we have is some dude on a gimbal just pushing in as he's rapping, pulling out, going around him. So we have those shots that are on the roof, and then all we have are like a couple drone shots here and there. That's it. But still, the video is like entertaining enough for me to like not get bored because the editor is putting in work. Props to you, editor, whoever you are. Yes, I know. That's what I'm saying. Fire. And what's dope about what he's saying right here is that like he's talking about his fans and how much he's got love for them. And that's one of the reasons why his fan base is as strong and as passionate as they are. Because one, they resonate with the music like heavily. Like that shit resonates in the soul. But also, it's a two-way street in terms of like how they feel about each other. Like NF loves his fans love him. It's like a reciprocating thing. And that's what drives it even more so. But the rhyme scheme right here is what I'm talking about. Like, give me two syllables at a time at least. I don't know how I got here in the first place. The glove is my birthplace. I don't mean to be rude, but I can get at you on my worst day. See what I mean? Two syllables at a time. It just flows so much better. And for those of you that don't know, because you're not from the United States and you don't understand like the geography and the shape of the states, Michigan is literally the shape of a glove. So the glove is my birthplace. Fire.
I don't wanna be rude, but I can get you on my worst. Say nothing for me, do it all the time. Yeah, they barely working while I'm working overtime. Last year they like who am I? Now this year they like you the guy. Here's a little something for your car rides. If they set up a love, they all lied. Yeah, you know the logo, better recognize. Yeah, it's real music to the day we die.
Fire. Dope. Dude, I love listening to rappers and their music before they like got to the level of fame that they got to. You looked over me like you passed me up and now I rose to the top. So thank you for giving me the fuel that I needed in order to get to the top where I'm at, because it was not an easy road. It wasn't paved for me all the way through. I had to fight for that shit. It's the same sentiment that Drake had on the So Far Gone mixtape. It's just like everybody that was ever looked past, and it's like just the rappers that don't necessarily fit into the stereotypical what rap should look like. White rappers, Drake, even though he's half white, half black, Jewish rapper, like not even from the hood, like from the middle class America. And what's even more dope about NF is that he doesn't have like radio hit popularity. Like he's growing in fame. His fan base is growing in like such a significant rate only because of his sure will and his skill and his different sound and all of that. And he does it without even cussing. I still have reservations about saying the word shit on his videos because I'm like, he's not cussing, I'm not cussing. But at the same time, he's doing him, so I'ma do me. And that means bringing some foul language every once in a while when I get hype. If they can say shit on TV, then I can say shit on YouTube. Shit, you know? But yo, that was dope. That's all there is to it. But yo, thank you everybody for watching this video. If you like what you see and you like the video, please like the video literally on the little thumbs up and leave a comment. All the activity on the video helps push the video out there for other people to see in the recommended section. So that way we can get this fan base, we can get this family growing, you know? If you like what you see enough, like I said at the beginning of the video, now that we're at the end, please consider clicking subscribing. If this is your first video, this is how we do it. If this is not your first video, this is probably like the third or fourth time I've asked you to click subscribe, and you've made it to the end of multiple videos if this is your third or fourth time hearing this. So just subscribe, you know? Like I said at the beginning, follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter. Those are the most common social medias, and those are the most active social medias that I have, at The Third Earnest, no spaces, just like the channel. Follow the Discord, join the Discord. I'm always up in there popping up and just chatting with everybody. Just a little chat room vibe. I appreciate everybody's time because I know that these videos are here longer, and I always say this, I know you can go out there in the world and watch reactions and breakdowns and all that from any artist, anybody that you want on YouTube. But you guys choose to spend your time here with me, so I try not to waste it. Your time is valuable. My time is valuable. I just need time. But that's the end of the video, guys. Thank you so much for being here. Like I always say at the very end, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other, and I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.